welcome back, everybody, to Banjo-Kazooie. It's very exciting today because we're going to go to the next level, but also we're going to be getting a ton of stuff in this video. This might even be a little bit of a longer one just because there's so much to get. Once we finish Gobi's Valley, of course, we have to go back and finish Freezeezy Peak, and we need to get the stop and swap items from Freezeezy Peak and Gobi's Valley. So we'll talk about all of that in this video. Thank you so much for joining me today. Of course, my name is Josh Jepson, and oh, I forgot this secret Mumbo token. If you watched the last video, you'll know that I opened up Gobi's Valley in the previous video, so go check that out if you haven't seen it yet. I know it's been a while, and I kind of had a break there because my computer exploded, which I mentioned in the previous video too, so, but we're back to daily uploads again. Isn't that exciting? I love Gobi's Valley. I'm ready for this. Gotta be careful of this burning sand. Burning deodorant. Yeah, I'm very excited about the stop and swap items that we're getting in this video, too. We'll do that right at the end after we've completed Gobi's Valley. So if you want to skip ahead to that to see what the codes are and stuff, you could totally do that. But let's talk to Bryntilda. Hi. I love starting episodes with talking to Bryntilda.
Grunty's best friend at high which school was
Saggy Maggie. Wait a minute. Why does that sound so familiar? Saggy Maggie? Isn't that a character in Banjo-Tooie? Saggy Mag, isn't that like, Jolly's, colleague, partner? I think that's what their name is.
When relaxing, she usually reads Fat Hag Monthly magazine.
Oh my God, they mentioned Fat Hag Monthly before. She was on the cover, riding her broomstick, right?
My memory is being jogged. Thank you.
While sipping a glass of her favorite smoothie.
Smoothie elephant sweat?
That is the most out of left field thing that she's said so far. It's not even elephant sweat smoothie. It's smoothie elephant sweat.
I don't even know.
You'll find one more move in here, Banjo.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, you'll find one more move in here, Banjo. Oh boy.
I gotta do the voice, man. I gotta do the voice. People be loving my my Mickey Mouse impression.
Ah, and this is the move. Ha. Don't think you can use these until you found out how. You can't wear shoes until you learn how to wear shoes.
Currently, Banjo and Kazooie do not know how to tie shoes. The only shoes that they've ever worn is those wading boots, which you don't have to tie at all.
So there we go. We gotta go find Bottle so he can teach us how to tie our shoes.
Oh my God. What a great level. This is also the last move that we're gonna get in the game too, those running shoes. So I'm very excited. Why does this, hang on, why is my face, why is Banjo's face carved into this ancient Sphinx door? Huh? Banjo, are you ancient? I feel like Banjo is ancient suddenly. I don't know. Anyway, like I said before, we're gonna get two stop and swap items in this video, so I figured I might as well like kind of do a little bit of a quick rundown on what stop and swap even is and what it was supposed to be. I talked about it a few episodes ago, but it's been some time, and you might have forgotten. But stop and swap was a feature that was essentially you would collect a bunch of items, six eggs and an ice key in this game, and then when the sequel Banjo-Tooie came out, you were supposed to be able to take the cartridge out of the console and put the Banjo-Tooie cartridge in, and all of the items that you collected for Stomp and Swap in this game would transfer over to the new game, and you would unlock a bunch of extra features. But of course, because of the hardware changes that Nintendo made to the N64, they weren't really able to do that because the amount of time that the game stayed in the RAM was not long enough. It was like 3 seconds as opposed to 10 seconds from the original N64 hardware. So so they scrapped it, and then they brought it back later for the Xbox Live re-releases of, no,
I was too slow. Too slow. Only sand eels.
They do not serve our kind. Jesus, all right. Okay, I gotta go back up there though, so, cause I gotta go inside this Sphinx man. Yeah,
very excited. As of recording this, right now, tomorrow is a Nintendo Direct, and you may be seeing this in the future and you may have already seen that Nintendo Direct, but I'm very excited because I'm hoping, are you guys also hoping that there's gonna be more N64 game announcements for NSO expansion pack? because I feel like it's a pretty lackluster selection so far. Oh God, his nose is plugged up. I don't see how shooting eggs into your nose holes is going to unblock your nose. And if anything, it's gonna block your nose up more. But hey, you know what? You do you, boo. Oh, I missed. Oh, I missed. There we go. Third time's the charm. I guess it causes him to sneeze, so that's what when it unblocks, I suppose. Ah! Oh, I did the camera's screwing me here. Frick, man. You know what? There are things in the N64 games that live on in my nightmares. One of them is Dead Hand from Ocarina of Time, and the other one is that freaking mummy hand in this level. All right? Grabba, I guess, or Slappa, I guess, is the name of that particular enemy. Slappa. Fitting name, really. All right, time for your snack. Nom, nom, nom. Here's some raw egg. Gross. Oh, no, oh, I still got it. I collected him through the bottom of the... This room gives some people a lot of trouble, I find. I remember as a kid falling off of here a lot. Because it's really hard to get the camera slow. So one tip that I have for anybody who's playing this game for the first time is another thing you can do is use the R button to recenter the camera behind Banjo. So like, for example, you can point Banjo in the direction that you want. It, you know, notice how the camera turns at like intervals, right? So it's really hard to aim the camera exactly where you want it to go. So if you want, you just aim Banjo where you want to aim the camera and then hold R. And then it kind of aims in that direction. You could actually keep holding it and turn Banjo around. So it's actually a better way of adjusting the camera more specifically. So that's a nice little tip for people that are struggling with like aiming their egg shots and stuff. Yeah, and then you know what? My other tip is don't fall and die. So there's that. Num num. Num num. You can't have dessert if you don't eat your raw eggs. Ugh, gross. Man, you know what I'm really hoping for from a Nintendo Direct in the future? I doubt we're gonna get it. Like, this is like above and beyond my biggest hopes. Is Rare Replay on the Switch. There was a survey going around from some Nintendo fan site recently that was, oh God! That was like asking some questions about the Switch and the state of it and stuff like that. I think it was called the State of the Switch or something. And I filled it out and I was like, hey, because one of the questions was like, what games would you love to see from other platforms come to the Switch? And I was like, Rare Replay, immediately. I was like, Rare Replay, let's go. That's like the best deal in gaming. Arguably, actually, the best deal in gaming is Game Pass, actually. I recently got my new PC, so I was like, oh man, I wish I had some more like new, like recent PC games to play. And I was like, all right, well, let's try Game Pass. It's only $1 to try it out. And so I got it, and it's so there's so many games. They have like Psychonauts. I should play Psychonauts. I've never played that game. Psychonauts 2 is on there too for free. I mean, not free. You have to pay for Game Pass, but it's $1 to start, and I think it's like $10 a month after that or something, which is really reasonable if you ask me. Really reasonable. No, I'm quite happy with my purchase. And I'm gonna be using that a lot. I actually, you know what? I'm a little disappointed though, because Rare Replay, on that subject of that, is not on the Game Pass. I think it's on Game Pass for Xbox. Like, you can play it on Xbox, but you cannot play it on PC, which is too bad. I think it would be really cool. And actually, I saw a tweet today that was like, Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts was originally planned to also release on PC, which would have been Games for Windows at the time. Not a good service. Games for Windows was awful. It got me thinking, I would love to see some really cool Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts mods. Could you imagine what modders could do with that game? Given that the game itself is already so deep with the vehicle customization and vehicle building that, like, the mod scene would be nuts for that game, I feel like it could add a lot of the things that people felt were missing from that game and fix a lot of the challenges and things that were not so good. Only joking, mortal. We could only give you this. I actually didn't read the first bit of the dialogue, so I don't know what he's joking about. I forgot, but you saw. Thank you for the jiggy. Thank you, thank you. But, like, think about it. How cool would that be? So, like, I don't know. I don't know if there's any mod support ever coming to Game Pass titles, but if there were, I'd love to see Nuts and Bolts appear on there and be moddable for sure. That would be so cool to have. All right. Let's go inside this pyramid. Let's go inside this pyramid and meet my favorite character in the game. And no, it's not who you're thinking it is. It's not, if you play the game, it's not who you think it is. Check it out. It's our boys, Ruby and our boy Toots.
Hello, my friend. I am Ruby. Can I be of some help? No?
We're looking for treasure, pipe boy.
Very good. I see some up there. It's yours if you can get it, yes?
Nah, guys. Ruby's not my favorite character. It's Toots! Toots is my favorite. Look at him! He's a little pink. I don't even know what he is. He's like a fish? Is he a fish? He's a land fish. But he's got a big snout like an anteater or an elephant. But he's like a little pink blob. Look at him. He's so cute. Who doesn't love Toots? I love them. Favorite characters in the game. So cool. Ruby does not appear in Banjo-Tooie, but I believe Toots does. And then they're never seen again. Many characters were lost to Nuts and Bolts. But some were brought back. It was kind of interesting to see like who they brought back and how they redesigned them in Nuts and Bolts. All right, let's poop some eggs. We have to feed the snake god his tub. Why does it gotta make... Listen, I know that Kazooie's out here farting out some eggs, but why is it gonna make like a super realistic fart sound? You know what I mean? My little kid brain thought that was so funny. Eh, farts are still kind of funny. Am I wrong, though? All right, I'm just gonna... Oop. Normally, you can just ride him up, but I'm just gonna climb. This level has one of the greatest tunes in the whole game, too. Gobi's Valley is such a memorable tune. You know, I was just humming Banjo-Kazooie tunes to myself the other day. I was just, like, throwing away my trash, and I was like... I was whistling ClickClock Wood to myself. Alrighty. That shit's stuck in my head, man. Good job, Grant.
Oh, oh boy! These are the running shoes! Ha ha! Beaky wears them on her scrawny feet to make her run really fast for a limited time! Ha! Your energy is a little low. I'll fill it up for you. Oh boy! Well played, Banjo! Ha! You've now learned all the moves in the game.
There we go! Hey! That deserves a round of applause! Can I get some claps, please, in the comments section of this video? I need at least one or two claps, like just like that would be cool. I deserve it. A pat on the back, even, would be acceptable. I've done it. I would say that this is the official halfway point. Once you get all of the moves in the game. Low battery. Uh-oh. That's not good. Well, we'll have to power through this before my N64 controller dies. Which is not a thing you would have said in the 90s. My N64 controller is dead. Well, you know what you would have said, though? You would have said, oh man, my N64 controller died because the control stick, like, it's perished. People know the pain of the classic N64 controller joystick. Literal pain. You know, you got the Mario Party thing where you're like, like cutting a hole in your hand. All right, this is a unique new button that we haven't seen yet in the game. Just a button that activates an empty honeycomb piece somewhere in the level. So we'll have to get that at some point. I may forget though, so we don't want to do that. Let's take a ride on this magic carpet. I can show you the world. Shining, shimmering, splendid. Is that how that goes? I don't
know. It's too hot for Gobi. I need some shade. Please help.
Gobi sucks. Oh wait, maybe not that kind of shade? Okay. Okay, I'll help you. Gobi doesn't suck. Gobi's a good boy. Help me out, Gobi. Here's your reward, Bear. Gobi's off to cool down. Gobi, you Gobi cool. You earned it. Thanks for the jiggy, dude. Who out here trapping Gobi on this little island? Huh? Is it Grunty? Probably Grunty. That bitch. All right. Moving on. Oh my god, this level has one of my favorite areas. The center platform there is so cool. You guys will see in a minute, but let's do this first. This is one of my least favorite areas. Not least favorite, but I, you know what? For the amount of times that I have played through this video game, this room still stumps me. Not stumps me, but like, I don't know. I feel like I should have, oh god, this mummy. I was trying to do this move, but there we go. It's the only way to kill those mummies, by the way. If you just peck them, they're just gonna curl up into a ball and then respawn. Dicks. So yeah, this is just like a memory matching game, but, and it's not even that complicated. It's a 4x4 square. You would think that I should be able to remember everything in this 4x4 square. Let's see if I get flawlessly. That'd be kind of sick, actually. I gotta talk myself up more. We got a Kazooie. Maybe there's a Kazooie here. Oh my god. What is happening? All right, this one's Mumbo for sure. Oh my god. Dude, I talked some real shit on myself a minute ago, and I am flawlessly doing this at the moment. Let's see. This one. Okay, that's Banjo. Banjo's definitely here. Oh my god. What am I on? Okay, this is not an egg though, is it? No! I was so close to perfect. One day I will remember all. My memory is so bad, dude. I flew this game like 100 times, probably. I still screw it up. But, I mean, they give you so much time. Actually, I don't even know if you're timed on this one. Already halfway through this level, which is good because we had a lot to do, man. Because I'm going to have to go back to Freezeezy Peak and do one more jiggy there before we carry on. You know, I was talking about Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts mods earlier, but that's not a thing. If it was, I would be happy. But you know what is a thing? Banjo-Kazooie mods, like OG Banjo-Kazooie mods. There's a lot of them that have come out in the last 2 years. Modders have been busy during the pandemic. Yeah, there's this guy called Kirko Mods who's like probably the head, like the lead person for Banjo-Kazooie mods, I would say. He's made a lot of the highest quality ones, including this Banjo-Kazooie mod called Jiggies of Time, which is such a cool mod. Basically, it's a mod that takes areas from Ocarina of Time and turns them into Banjo-Kazooie levels. So full levels where you get 100 notes and 10 jiggies and like extra honeycomb pieces and there's platforming and jumping and it all looks like a Banjo-Kazooie level, but it's just like the layout is Ocarina of Time. Like you can go and do, there's a whole level of Kakariko Village, for example. I actually haven't looked too deep into it because I want to play it blind myself. And I plan to sometime after this Let's Play is finished. So, but there is one caveat. There's one caveat. This will only be unlocked if we obtain 50 total supporters over on patreon.com/Jepson. Check it out. I'm going to be posting a Banjo-Kazooie related video this week. It may or may not be related to Banjo-Kazooie mods. And that might get you a little enticed to try it out. If we hit 50 total, we're at 36 now, I think. So we hit 50 total patrons. Consider becoming one at any tier. And I will be doing Jiggies of Time here on the channel in its entirety for everyone to see. And Patreon will see the episodes early as well. So you'll get a little added bonus of being able to see that stuff early. Check it out. Highly recommend. Snack time, mother trucker. Why you gotta move? I'm just trying to feed you, dude. God, this is so cool. I love this area. You guys have no idea. Like this part of the game, this section, this pyramid here, scared the absolute ass out of me. Scared the poop out of me, dude. This is not a cool place. And you will see why. I will show you why. It's terrifying. All right. Everybody, welcome to King Sandy Butt's tomb.
This is King Sandy Butt's tomb. Turn back or face his wrath.
Also, what a great name, King Sandy Butt. All right, here we go. Ready?
You chose not to heed our warning. We have 60 seconds to make it through this maze, and if you don't, you get crushed by the spikes on the ceiling! All right, here we go!
Here, I got better use Kazooie, because I'm going to have to go a long way here. Because also, the witch switch is in this freaking maze. This is the exact way you want to go to get the witch switch. It's not a super complicated maze, and it does give you this nice top-down view, which makes it a little easier to get through, but this witch switch is very evil, because you're likely to only, like, if you don't know it's there, you're likely to only see it once you get to the end of the maze, and then you're like, oh, I gotta go back now, but I can't, because I only have 20 seconds. Like, not even. And the music gets faster and faster, and so nerve-wracking, dude. Anxiety-inducing, man.
No, the bear survived. He's after the king's ancient relic.
And we got it. This Jiggy was dead. This was the tomb of the... Actually, wait a minute. So if this is King Sandy Butt's tomb, and he's not in there, I guess he turns into a mummy and, like, goes somewhere. Where is King Sandy Butt? Who is King Sandy Butt? Where is he? I want to fight King Sandy Butt. Because I just realized just now, there's not really a boss character in this level. Like, most levels in this game, like, the first, like, Mumbo's Mountain, right, has Conga, you know? Treasure Trove Cove has Nipper. Clanker's Cavern has, well, Clanker, technically, but he's not really a boss, I guess. I guess the Muty Snippets, the little green crabs. Is there anything else in here? Just want to double check. I think I went in all of these pots. Okay, I think I got everything. Was that also the last Jinjo? No, it was not. There's one more Jinjo. Blue Jinjo. What else is there? Let's see. Fourth level, Bubblegum Swamp. There's like a couple of options for like what the boss could be, like Mr. Vile or even the Flibbits. But there's not really a boss-esque fight in this area except for going through the maze. Like, that's the closest to a boss fight that you get in this level, I guess. You know what? Before I forget about it, because I'm thinking about it right now, I'm going to go to that fly pad on top of Jinxie over here. Actually, there's a secret fly pad. Not secret, really, but... is it down? Where is it? Is it right below me here? Oh, I wish I could see. Here, I'm going to go down anyway. Fuck it. Yeah, there it is. Ha ha. Oh, don't burn. This is just so you can get back out and not burn alive in the sand hole. For the most part. Don't burn alive in the sand hole. I want to get that empty honeycomb piece in the cactus before I forget. Because I have done that before. All right. Thread the needle. Oh, no. Ow. Oh, not a good needle threading. Okay. We done did it. Ah! Now I'm being grabbed out of this. Bro, we gotta go up, dude. You can't be doing shh like that, man. Brick. Frickin' fracking. Okay. Oh my god, I am making every mistake in the book. I'm gonna die. Alright, there's bees here, but I really need help, so I'm just gonna quickly. Just don't attack me. No! Ah! Bees! Help! Okay, it's fine. All right, let me kill this guy so that he's not in my way for this next part. Oh, God, Jesus! I'm gonna get out of the way. Wow, he really do slap real far. Smack. There we go. At least they're not too bad to kill. Also, there's like it bursts into, like, it's really gross. Like, you see the insides of his destroyed fingers. Disgusting. Okay, let's do this first. Whoop. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, no. Oh, this is bad. Hold on. Let me get these notes first, and then we'll do this part. I'm gonna like take. I'm taking so much damage. I'm being like extra careless today. Once I start learning how to speedrun this game, which is gonna be like next month, I can't be making mistakes like that. I can't be jumping in the sand for no reason. Ah, yes.
Grabba's got a jiggy.
Give me it, Grabba. Bear's too slow. Are you seeing? Are you picking up what we're throwing down here? Do you know what we need to do? Because I don't. Just kidding. We gotta run real fast and not get stung in the process. Especially because I don't have that much health left, and I kind of don't want to die with like 80 jiggy or 80 notes. Whee! All right, Grabba, you and me. I guess Grabba's kind of boss-like. Not really. You don't fight him though. You just steal his jiggy that he's been holding for 1,000 years. Dude, you gotta feel so bad, like just like holding on to this treasure for 1,000 years, and then just some barren bird show up and steal it from you. And it's not even that big of a deal to them. They have like 50 other jiggies at this point. Alrighty. So next up is this big pyramid here. And we gotta get up it real quick, so let's grab this. Hit this bouton. Bouton. God, I hate how long this... I hate that the countdown continues during the cutscene. I think most of the time I miss this first one because I'm going out of my way for these notes as I go up. Because these are some pretty missable notes. Because you're already trying to rush to the hole. And you kind of got to jump up it sideways. Oh, I missed. All right, hold on. That's fine. I needed to get the rest of those anyway.
Grunty's race you cannot beat until you find some faster feet.
Feet.
All right. Attempt number 2, which may not be my last attempt. Sometimes I do this and I'm on the struggle bus. Let's see if today is nope. See, yep. The camera already being changed on me.
It's not helping. No, 4, 3, 2, and it starts closing right here. No!
Totally blue balled. God damn, dude. All right, third time's the charm, as they say. See, like it zooms the camera out and then it puts it behind you. Oh no, it doesn't. Sometimes it, what the hell, camera? Sometimes it puts it behind me and sometimes it puts it on the side and I have no idea. N64 games, man, they are fantastic and very nostalgic, but the limits of the technology at the time, I'll tell you what. All right, guys, very important. I guess it's not that important, but there's a missable. Missable. I think it's the only one in the whole game. The only thing in the whole game that's missable. Got him. There's an Ikumbogum up there, and as soon as you get this jiggy, the whole world empties out. Yeah, I know there's a low battery. Get out of my screen. Shut up, controller. I'm busy. If you're gonna die, you're gonna die. I can't help you. I suppose I could plug it in. After. Watch it die at the worst part. And I just like, I probably die. Given how little health I have, I'll probably perish here pretty quick. Well, let's go and get the rest of the notes as fast as humanly possible. I think the only other notes left are the ones under here. And then there's like one other spot that I need to go to. I think there's also the blue Jinjo down here too.
92. Yay, there's the blue ginger. Let's get that jiggy real quick before I drown. All right, what's the one last jiggy that I'm missing? Oh, it's Gobi. We need to go talk to Gobi again. Our boy. Ikumbokum again. I think I've gotten almost every Ikumbokum in the game. If I miss one and you know where it is, let me know in the comment section because I want to try to get them all if I can. I'll probably miss a couple, but they're not necessary. Like, you have so many more than you need anyway, so. All right, before I perish from my controller dying, I want to take this. Ah, no! Oh, no! 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 All right, I'm going to take a break and let my controller charge, and then I'm going to come back and recollect 96 notes! 95! What? Okay. Whoops! Ah, come on now. What an awful way to get all the 95 notes again. What an awful way. Here, give me your freaking honey. Thank you. Jesus. You know, if I just went out of my way for some health once in a while when I, you know, when I got low, instead of just being risky about everything, I probably wouldn't have died here. Maybe I should fly. Wait. Actually, you know what? Let's do this first. Because this makes more sense. Let's go get that last jiggy real quick. Ah, Jesus. Oh, God. We need to stop having, like, this be a horror game. This needs to stop being a horror game real quick. Yo, what's up?
This tree looks a bit thirsty, but I need all my water for myself.
Wow. Way to be a little selfish. Wait, what? There's water everywhere here, though. Hold on. What? For one, why is the tree thirsty? Two, why can't you drink more water after I do this? Sorry, Gobi. Pain, suffering.
Ah, lovely water. Chunker feels great.
You're welcome, Trunker. You're welcome. Thank you for the jiggy. Look at how tall and thin you are. I love how instead of the tree just like actually growing, the way they do it is just smoosh it up like it's Play-Doh. All right, there we go. All 10 jiggies. I think I also got both of the empty honeycomb pieces too, right? Did I not? No, I'm missing one. I'm missing one. I'm missing one. Wherefore art thou, honeycomb? All right, I'm gonna actually fly to this next area. Because you can just take that magic carpet ride up to where we're going, but I'm just gonna not. Because last time it was pain. Last time it was suffering. And of course, the last 5 notes were up here too. Beep, beep, beep. Well, hey, you just passed your note score. Yay.
Ha! Huh, you found all 100 notes on this world. Well done, Banjo. Ha! Oh boy.
Yo, what's up, Gobi? You want to talk to me? I'm sorry. I'm sorry, man. Can you ever? Oh, jeez, that's way too close. Can you, Gobi? Can you ever forgive me? Can you ever forgive me for slapping your hump? Sorry, I gotta do it again though, cause like you got the empty honeycomb piece I'm looking for. Bah, that's it. I'm leaving this desert. Find some peace and quiet. See ya. And that's everything. Except for the stop and swap item, which is right in there. It's in this tomb. It's right here in this wall, but we can't access it. Imagine being a 10-year-old child playing this game for the first time in like the late 90s. And that's closed. And you're like, what is behind the door number one? I don't know, I'll never know. I guess I gotta wait for the magic carpet ride to come back. All right, here it comes. Hello, carpet. Alrighty, well, let's go back now to Freezeezy Peak. Actually, before we go to Freezeezy Peak, I am gonna go and open up both of those doors now. And then we'll go back to Freezeezy Peak, get the ice key, number one,
and get the blue egg, which is behind door number one here. But we got to go back to Treasure Trove Cove first. So I will head over there now. Ah, why do you keep going? Then you'll get a grunty pounding. Smash or pass? I'm gonna pass. Okay, so I'm gonna put the code on the screen for both of these things, but you're gonna have to give me a second because it's gonna take like 7 hours to type it in. But here we go. The first one is for the ice key in Freezeezy Peak, cheat. First, you gotta type in the word cheat before anything else. And then the code is, now you can see a nice ice key, which you can have for free. So here we go. Freaky. I asked for ice puns in the last video, and the biggest ice pun of them all was this code. Now you can see a nice ice key, which you can have for free. It's also kind of a tongue twister. Say that 10 times fast in the comment section. All right. Next up, we do want to unlock the egg in Gobi's Valley, which is, of course, you type cheat first, and then it is a desert door opens wide. Ancient secrets wait inside. So, you know, give me like 1,000 years and I'll get it done. S I D E. A desert door opens wide. Ancient secrets wait inside. Wait, didn't, huh? I must have typed something wrong. Is it gonna work this time? I'm not even sure what I screwed up last time. Man, it worked. I don't know what I typed wrong last time, but there you go. It's open. All right. Whatever. Here we go. Let's go get some stop and swap items. And while we are on our way there, I would like to tell you a little bit of a story about stop and swap and my connection to it. When Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts was first announced, I was probably one of the Banjo fans that was the most excited. I was very ready for it, even though it looked very different. I was very ready for it. Very excited for it. And I signed up for the Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts forums. And yeah, that was a thing. And I made actually quite a good few friends there. And at one point they held a contest. And the contest was basically you had to design a vehicle that would then be put into the game, which was unlockable through Stop and Swap on the Xbox, not on the original, obviously. So if you got the Stop and Swap items in Banjo-Kazooie Xbox Live Arcade and Banjo-Tooie Xbox Live Arcade, and then you played Nuts and Bolts, you would unlock extra vehicle parts, and you would unlock pre-built vehicles that were made by the community. And one of them was a rotating, like, anti-air gun turret. They just called it rotating turret. That's my vehicle. I made that. I was one of the winners of this contest, this build contest. And the reason why mine was picked was because it was such a unique design that allowed like a free rotating movement of the top of the turret, and it had like a little gun on it and you could shoot. It actually was useful in a couple of the games as well. Like there was one Nuts and Bolts challenge where you had to kill a bunch of stuff that was flying around. And yeah, so like that's the coolest thing in my Banjo-Kazooie repertoire is that I have some connection to Stop and Swap. So if you play Nuts and Bolts and you play it on Xbox and you get all the Stop and Swap items, right now on Rare Replay, you can unlock that turret vehicle that I made in like 2000 and when did that game come out? 2011? I don't even know. Probably earlier than that. 2008, I think, is when that came out. So check it out. And if you think that's cool, leave a comment down below. Because that's like one of the coolest stories that I have. Cool, an enormous ice key. We gotta keep this for later. Yes, we should. I agree, Kazooie. Before we go and get that egg from the...
Eek! The bear again!
I think he says that, take that orange squawking thing out of here or something. Before we leave Freezeezy Peak, though, we do have one more check stop because we're missing a Jiggy in this level, as you might recall, and we couldn't get it because we didn't have the running shoes. Now we have the running shoes. Let's go challenge Boggy to another frickin' race. This is the harder of the two races, for sure. So, Boggy?
Hey, buddy, fancy a race against Boggy? Press A to accept, beat a chicken out.
Yeah, I'm down. I love how last time he's like, I wanna race somebody my own size. And then this is the race with the character of his own size. Or so he thinks. I mean, yeah, they're both bears, but Boggy, you're significantly thicker. All right, boys, let's go. Also, fun fact, if you go into the water, you will lose almost instantaneously because you lose the ability to run real fast. You lose your heckin' shoes in the water. So do not fall in the water. I think you can technically touch the water as the walrus in the first race, but still not recommended because you take damage well, actually, with the walrus, you probably don't take damage, huh? God, the rubber banding on this second race is so wild. Look how fast he's going suddenly. Like, God damn it, dude. Like, slow down. Like, he's, like, putting his whole life into this. This is his thing, man. All right, no, that's fine. See, all you got to do is jump around. Flawless victory. Let's heckin' go. Just shove me out of the way. Lost again. Take my other medal. I'll have to look for my kid's presents. About that. Already did that for you, buddy. What a garbage father. What a bad dude. You need to be better to your kids, Boggy. This is a lesson to you, sir. Actually, I kind of want to go and see. I think he shows up at his house next time you load the area. So let me go see if he's even at his house right now. Ooh, almost smacked my face in the wall. Good job, Banjo. Man, Boggy, how did you get here before me? Second of all, how are you already asleep, you lazy bastard?
I wish those kids would be quiet. Old Boggy needs some sleep.
What the f- Excuse my French. What the fuck? Are you serious? Man, whoever designed Boggy and wrote his dialogue has some daddy issues, I think. All right, moving on. Next stop and swap item. Check that off the list.
Arabian nights are like Arabian days.
I don't actually know the words to that song. I just wanted to sing some more Aladdin songs. All right, here we go. Blue egg. Oh, there's a button and everything. I love it. So majestic.
Wow, another one of those special eggs.
No kidding, Banjo. All right, guys, that is it for this episode of Banjo-Kazooie. What an exhausting episode between dying and having to go back and backtrack to Freezeezy Peak and going back and getting all the stop and swap stuff that we hadn't missed yet. I still need to go and get the Witch Jiggy from Freezeezy Peak, but we'll save that until after the next level because then I can get two Witch Jiggies at one time, so... that is it for this episode. Again, make sure you check out the Patreon and support over there. We're trying to hit 50 total supporters over on Patreon. We're getting close. We're at 36 currently. And if you support at any tier, you can help us get towards that goal. And when we do, I will be playing the Banjo-Kazooie mod, Jiggies of Time, here on the channel, and patrons will be able to see them early. So thank you so much for watching. My name is Josh Jepson, and I will see you guys in the next one.